Hi everybody, this video is going to take you through the process of making branded PowerPoints. So I've chosen one of the organizations that I work with a lot, the Norfolk Botanical Garden, which is a wonderful organization in the city because it does a lot with the community as well as just provides this amazing service and amazing place for us to enjoy. So I wanted to just show you really quickly what this PowerPoint looks like. And then we can go through and I can show you how I made it. So there are, I'm just going to show you various ways of doing things here rather than make one coherent, consistent PowerPoint. So you can see that each slide here is really, really different. And there's no content either. These last slides actually use transitions and animations. And in many cases, if you're using PowerPoint on something else, you can't actually use those. And so I'm not actually going to go in depth into how you do that. That would be in a different video. But I will show you a little bit just to show you the difference between making a PowerPoint and doing something like VoiceThread, which might not be able to translate all of those materials. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to a PowerPoint and make a new presentation. So if I go into PowerPoint here, I go to New and then Blank Presentation. And it's really important that you do that because the reality of PowerPoint is that people tend to make things that are from existing templates. So they'll use design and they'll go through and they'll choose one of these. And there's a lot of really cool things in here. And you can find a whole bunch online. The problem is that these are things that a lot of other people have already used. And so they're immediately recognizable. I have not hired people specifically because they used a PowerPoint template, a standard, what we call a deck. Rather than actually making something themselves, it shows that they just didn't really think about me or who was who they were presenting to. And for marketing and public relations, that's killer. You can't do that. So I'm going to just go through and show you some basic things here. The first is just to make a decent title slide. And one of the first things you need to do for a title slide is to make a get their logo. And so what I'm going to do is pull up Firefox here. And I'm just going to go to images.google.com and I'm going to search for Norfolk Botanical Garden logo. And what I want to do is make sure that I go to tools and color and transparent. I really want to make sure that the background of these is transparent. And notice there's a whole bunch of different ones here. And that can be really useful depending on what you're doing. What you really want to make sure to do when you're making a branded deck is actually look up the website of the organization. That should give you the most current or most recent brand. And you can see that this is the logo that they are using right now. And so you'd want to choose this this logo. They have used, and you can see them using other logos in various places, particularly with slightly different colors here. But we're going to use this one, so the deck is actually going to look different than the one that I just made. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go back into here. This is the logo, so I'm going to click on it, and then right click or option click if you're using a Mac, save the image. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. And the reason you want to use this transparency is because when we are going through and using this, we want to make sure that whatever is behind this logo shows through. So if I wanted to put like a different color behind it, I could, and that would be fine. So I'm just going to put this in the bottom right-hand corner of the deck for now. And I'm going to shrink that down a little bit because it's a little big. So this should give me a lot of clues, and so does the website in terms of what things look like. But one thing that I wanted to emphasize here is that you should not do this. Like, don't go to these design ideas and choose these. You can go ahead and use them for inspiration, and they actually give you some really cool ideas, but do not actually use them because you're kind of locked into that design and you can't edit it. And it also just, again, it looks like you didn't put any effort in. So I'm just going to jazz this up a little bit. So I'm going to bring in an image. And in this case, this image is something that I took myself in my neighborhood. And I want to show you that that's something that you can do and that I would recommend doing. Otherwise, remember that your clients or any organization will have a website or an Instagram page, and they will, have content there, have what we call assets, have them there. And so you should always use those. So I'm going to just do a couple little things here, but you can see all this white space just doesn't look good. So if I put in making a branded PowerPoint, right? That's one way to do it. But you can see here that there's a couple of issues already, that the logo doesn't use capital letters, so I should change these to mimic the logo. And this doesn't look at all like that copy or that font. I'm not going to be able to find this font, and that's okay, I think, for this point. Don't worry about it too much. You just don't want it to be too completely different. Okay, so I'm going to make this a little thicker, and I'm just going to do that with bold. And then I'm going to go ahead and change my font and see if I can find something that's a little different. Arial seems a little closer. It's not a serif font, which is useful. And I think Arial is going to be the closest that I'm going to use here. Really, what this is a kind of cursive font, and cursive fonts are extremely difficult to match. And so I'm not even going to try to match it, because if I try to go too close, but it's not quite there, it's just going to look weird. If I was going to actually do this, I would make it completely matched and then go from there. So you can see that this looks plain in the little preview here. So what I'm going to do is just insert a shape, and I'm just going to make a square here. And at first, I'm going to make it the same size that I want it to eventually look like, so about here, maybe a little bit less. And then I'm going to right click, or again option click, and send it to the back. So I send it all the way backwards. So you can think of these as layers stacked on top of one another. And so I just sent this to the bottom of the deck, like a deck of cards. And so it still doesn't look quite right. So I'm going to click on the author name here, and then I'm going to hold down shift and then click again here, so that I get a different color. And then I'm going to change the color. So that looks a little better, but the color of this blue is just not working at all. So I'm going to go ahead and change the fill here, and I'm going to use the eyedropper tool and choose a darker color, like this one, this dark blue. And then I'm going to take my outline, which I normally don't use. I normally remove the outline, but in this case, I'm going to actually grab one side, this light blue. And I'm going to make it really thick. So I'm going to give it a weight of 6. And you can actually make that as thick as you want. You can adjust it. You can even make different colors. I'm sorry, dashed lines and things like that, which I don't want. But okay, so here you can see this is looking pretty good. I'm going to pull this in a little bit. Actually, I'm just going to press the left arrow because PowerPoint sometimes doesn't like it when you do that. It tries to snap. So this is getting a little better. I'm not sure if I really like these two colors together, so I might want to go ahead and change these to different colors, but for right now, I'm not going to worry about it. This looks okay. One thing I do want to do, though, is make this box a little bigger. And the reason is that I don't want the outline to be on the left edge and on the top. I just want it to be on the inside as a border. And so you can see what this looks like here. And that's not so bad. That actually looks like a pretty decent deck. There's other things that you could do, for instance, to the copy here. You could add an effect, like a shadow. And I actually do like drop shadows a lot. Other people don't necessarily, and you can go into your shadow options and choose how far away you want them and things like that. And that's really, really fun. So I recommend playing with those things because they can make a big difference. But you can see here that what it does is it just makes things pop off the screen a little bit, which is nice. Okay. So this is actually the hardest of any of the slides that I'm going to do today, which is good because we're getting to 10 minutes. So I'm going to make a new slide. And then in here, what I'm going to do is choose a different, I'm just pulling that one up for reference so I remember what I'm doing here. I'm going to choose a different image. And for that, I'm going to go back into Firefox and I'm going to go to their Instagram page. And the image that I've actually chosen is this one here. And I've already downloaded that, so I'm not going to go through the process, but you can click on it and then you can option click. And it should let you download it, but maybe it's not going to let you download it from here because Instagram tries to get you to not download things. So what you would do is probably take a screen capture of this. In Windows, that's really easy. It's this snip and sketch tool, and you can just go to the window, the start menu, and then press snip, and that will get it for you. Or I think QuickTime does it, but there's lots of ways to do screen grabs, and you can certainly look those up. But I've already grabbed this image, so I'm not going to go through that process, just because we don't have a ton of time. So what I'm actually going to do is, just paste that in. And you can see again, it gives us these design ideas. And a lot of them are really cool, but get inspiration, but don't use these. Okay, so the first thing that people tend to, so I'm going to go ahead and again move this all the way to the back. The first thing that people tend to do with images, which you do not want to do because it looks like crap, is to make it into a background that looks like this. And then you put your copy on top, like, just background. And then we can go ahead and make our copy white here. And so even if we do something like add a drop shadow or something, it's just not going to work. It really just doesn't look good. And so what you'll see is if we add our shadow, it pops it a little bit. But when you add enough text, especially if there's a really strong image like this, you just can barely see it. And that's not what you want. So what people tend to do is they go to this image and they go to picture format and they reduce their transparency. And this looks horrible. So what they're doing, oops, here we go. What they're doing is just making this image transparent, and what's behind it is white, so it ends up fading it out. And that just looks bad. It doesn't matter what color your copy is, it always looks bad. So what I'm going to do is just make a new slide and show you another way to do this, which is to be, again, it's going to bring this stupid design ideas thing. I'm going to send it to the back, and I'm just going to leave this as is. And the reason is that we don't really, so remember that this image, by the way, is off the screen a little bit here. And so we don't know where the edge is, so you can drag it down and figure that out. And you can always preview the slideshow to see how much of it is there. So in this case, this doesn't look bad. And so I'm going to just add some content in here, but I want to jazz up my title a little bit. So I'm going to go back to the logo. And I'm going to paste that back in. I don't want to use the logo, but I do want to use the colors. So what I'm going to do here is again do backgrounds, and I'm going to go to Arial and make it bold. I can always make this lowercase as well, so it matches the copy. And then again, I want to insert a shape, and so this shape I'm going to make around the same size as the background. And I want to pull off my outline here. And what I want to do in this case is actually go to gradient fill. And you can get there by clicking on this little box and it will open up this thing here. So I want to go, or you can go to shape fill, gradient, more gradients. So I want to go to gradient fill, and I want to basically, this is a linear gradient, meaning it starts from what, this is radial here, it means it starts from the middle and radiates out like a circle. This is linear, it goes from one end to the other end. So what I'm going to do is click here and then choose my color. I'm going to go to the eyedropper and I'm going to highlight that same blue from before. And then I'm going to go all the way to the left and do the same thing here. And then I'm going to go to the middle and choose a middle one because I don't really know if this is a pure gradient or if they've messed with it at all. And so then I'm going to maybe move it about halfway since I chose about halfway. And I'm going to choose a linear. And the direction I'm going to choose is from left to right. So when I've got this gradient, what I want to do is go ahead and don't use the stock PowerPoint title thing that they put up there. So I deleted that off. But what you need to do is go and insert a new text box and type in background, and then I'm going to make that bold, make that Arial, and then I'm going to make it bigger. And then once it's on top of that gradient, and you can make it even bigger if you want, you want it to fill as much of that as possible, then we can make sure that you, I'm going to make this a little smaller. Great. And I'm just holding down shift to highlight both of these things. And then you go back into format, click on the merge tool, and you can see what these do. In this case, what I'm trying to do is intersect them. And that was a little strange. I don't know why it did that. But let's see here. Let's try again. There we go. Intersect. So I don't know why it didn't happen the first time, but you can always play around. But you can see that this gives you a really nice way to play with things. The problem is that once you do this, the text is no longer editable. So make sure that you have the text right before you do this. And if you do this, you have to redo it every single time. And that is really, really annoying. So I'm going to show you a couple other ways to make this look good without having to go through that process. So one of those ways is to just do something really simple. And so in this case, I think what I put in here was like the parent's perspective or something. The parent perspective. And then again, some copy. So this is fine. But and what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this image again. So Control C or Command C and then Control V. But I don't want it to use this entire image. What I want to do is actually crop this down. And so if I right click on it, it's going to give me this crop button here. And so what I want is to actually, ooh, not do that. Undo. And you can see that this is allowing me to move this around, but also make it smaller. And just cut out, no, I'm sorry, not making it smaller, I'm just cutting out different pieces, just cropping it down. So this is a good one, and I think I'll go ahead and leave it like this, and then I'm going to click out. And what I'm going to do is just use this to make design elements, and as opposed to just having like a bar. So in some cases, what you could do is, and you can redo this. So if I go back into crop, so one thing you could do is actually make the entire bar here. So in that case, it would look like just a design element like this, which looks really good. And that's certainly not a problem. And then you can mess with that. So one of the things I often do is use the morph tool and mess with that quite a bit. But what I'm going to do in this case is just bring some life to it by having some elements that might move if I want them to later on. So I'm going to copy and paste this. So Control C, Control V. And then I'm going to drag this down. And then I'm going to shift and highlight the other one. Then Control C, Control V. And I'm going to have them stop doing that. And then you can see that these aren't quite even. So I'm going to highlight them all. And I'm going to go right click and go to, oh, let's see here. Maybe it's not going to let me do this because they are. Nope, it will. Go to arrange and then align and distribute vertically. So basically, it puts them even with each other. So now I've got these images, and you know that looks kind of cool, but it doesn't look exactly the way I want it to look, and that's because these images are all the same. And so what I'm going to do is go back to crop. And just shift what part of this image each of them is on. And you can see that suddenly this really pretty image has become a set of really pretty design elements. And like I said, you can animate those design elements in various ways as you go. And so that's one thing you can do. You can put that on the left. You can put that at the bottom. You could use pieces of different Instagram photos if you wanted to, whatever you wanted to do. So I'm going to create a new slide again, and I'm going to do just one more to show you. And then I think I'll maybe duplicate that just so you can see how the morph and transition things work. All right, so I'm gonna make something called introduction as the copy, and then again I'm gonna paste in that image, and I only want one of them, and I'm gonna drag this in, and I'm going to go back to crop, and I'm going to make it bigger. That way. And I like that actually, so I think that works. Okay. But I just want that to be all the way on the screen. Okay. Then I'm going to right click, send it to the back, and then I'm going to grab my copy here and I'm going to make it white. Oops. Bold and then bigger. Okay. So you can see, obviously, this is not always easy, but that's a really cool little design element that you can do. And so I'm going to go through and duplicate this slide. So Control D or Command D. And then I'm going to change my title on the second one. And once that title is changed, I also want to change this. But again, I don't necessarily need to change the photo. I can just move it. So I'm going to just move it up. And so, it's weird. Okay, there we go. So there we go. So what I want to do at this point is transition here. And I'm going to use the morph transition. And what that does is it allows you to have a design element that is the same element. So if you duplicate that element or copy and paste that element, and that same element changes, it moves, it automatically animates. And that's really cool because with crop, it actually looks as if the image is moving behind. And so what I don't really like is the transition with the copy here. And so I'm actually going to delete that out because that's weird. It shouldn't do that. Sometimes it does this. So I'm going to click back here, Control C, click back into the other slide, Control V, and let's see if it does it this time. It shouldn't, but you never know. So what we have here is that, and I'll click. Oh, it's still doing it. And it could just be that I'm using the main title thing versus adding my own copy. And so you could always cut that out and try it, but play around with these. And again, you can do the same thing with those little four boxes. So the other thing you can do here is on the first slide, if you don't want it to transition, you can do something really fun like an animation. And so in this case, maybe I want to have this fly in, and I want to have it fly in from the left. And so I wouldn't want to do that here on the second one because it's morphing in, but you can see what that's going to look like. So when I go to my deck here, I can click and I can see it slides, and then I would go through, and then this brings us to the next slide. So these are all the ways of making a really nice branded deck. One thing I would recommend is considering incorporating the logo on every slide. But the nice thing about this is because we're using content from the garden, you don't necessarily have to have that. And in this case, if you have the same colors, then you can do it that way. One other thing you could do is take some kind of design element from their website or from one of their logos, like one of the leaves or something like that. Shrink it down and actually add it in as a customized bullet, which is very, very simple. You just go into the bullets menu in home, and then in bullets, you can go to bullets and numbering, and then you can choose a picture. And then I could choose that their logo or something like that. So that would be really, really simple to do. So from a file, I'll choose their logo and see how that looks. And you can see that there the logo is really small, and that's fine. You could do it that way. But I don't think that looks as good as, for instance, using a little leaf or something like that. But those are the various ways that you can create a really lovely branded PowerPoint deck. Make sure that you go to their Instagram or other social, and make sure you go to their website, and you can get some really, really cool content that makes them feel that you know who they are and that you care about them. Good luck.